This error is when you install another version of software. For example, your computer is using 64-bit operating system, but the software failed to install 32-bit. So that installation file is still stored in the computer memory, and usually when you start the computer, the software will start according to Windows. But it is shortened by 64-bit version and cannot be booted, so an error occurs. To erase the root and no longer show up on your computer, do the following. First, we have to find the path to save that file. Let's delete these two files. On the computer are using the 64-bit version, but these two files are 32-bit. Remember to delete all. Before installing the software, we should check what operating system our computer is using. How many bits, how much RAM? Then go online to find the correct version that matches the configuration and download it so it will not take time and no error. After deleting, you should go both to recycle bin and delete all. Next, go to control panel greater than programs and features and check if something is strange, then remove it. There are software we did not install but still found it on the computer. The first is that the Windows software is available when Windows has a new update, which you do not have to uninstall because it does not affect. The second is the software it is in the installation files that you install but do not pay attention to click next to install it. So when installing, regardless of software, you must read slowly step by step before clicking next. Currently on this computer there is an error due to installing VLC32 software on a 64-bit computer. So I have to find what files VLC related is to delete. If manual search fails, we can download regedit cleaning tools such as CCleaner, PC Decrapifier, Cleanup. Also on the video I am using the manual removal method, so it took a bit of time. Next I will go to Task Manager to find out if there is anything strange to remove it. Task Manager utility is very convenient. It can show strange software running in the background and help us to turn it off and find the path of the file. From the search bar you can also type msconfig and press the Enter key to enter the system configuration utility. The system configuration utility, or msconfig.exe, is used to manage the processes that occur when the Windows system starts. Its graphical interface is very simple to control the various boot processes and configuration files used. It is also the first tool we will use if we want to speed up the boot, as it allows us to turn programs on and off in startup mode. We will use it to predict a system crash. Click on Startup, click Open Task Manager and select the Startup tab. Here there is any file with doubts or the same name with synaptics.exe bad image, you must disable or delete it. You see that the file in the third row is called Synaptics, so it's the file it starts up with Windows. Now you right-click on it and choose Open File Location to open its root folder. You proceed to delete its MUACJ messages. Here you right-click and select Disable it. Okay, now close all windows and restart your computer to see the results.